copper is a really good electrical conductor. And since our audio signals are electrical signals, copper does a great job at moving that signal through the cable. But one simple copper wire won't make a solid audio connection. Every audio cable also needs a separate connection to ground. We do this with a shield, which is also made of copper. This protects the audio from noisy interference, and if you didn't have a shield, you'd hear a ton of buzz. So we have the center copper wire, which carries the audio signal, and we have the shield that surrounds it. This is the simplest way to make an audio connection and is called unbalanced. Mostly, you'll see this on instrument connections like guitars, basses, or keyboards. And it's totally fine to use, you just can't run it very far. After about 20 feet, you'll start to lose audio quality with an unbalanced connection. To have a true balanced connection, you need a balanced cable. Now, this is very similar to an unbalanced cable, it just has an extra signal wire. So we have this shield and two signal wires. While the first wire just carries the signal like normal, the second wire carries a signal that is out of phase with the first one. Well, you can think of noise as a wave trying to get into the cable. And if it gets into the signal wires, we'll have the same noise in both of our cables and it will be in phase. But when our balanced signal reaches the destination, the audio circuit flips the phase of the second wire. So the noise ends up being out of phase and canceled out, and the audio signal ends up being in phase. This is called common mode rejection. This is a really effective trick, and like I said, you can run balanced audio really far.